not every stripper pole dances and not every pole dancer strips. I hear these throwaway comments sometimes when people come to class.
Now, I don't know, how do you make time for fun?
There's no time for fun.
Hi guys, and welcome back to Snacks and Chats. I'm excited about our guest today. She's amazing. Right, before we even jump into it, I knew this girl from secondary school. She's amazing, she's an actress, she's a pole instructor, but most of all, she's a business owner. Now, Kelechi, please, tell me who you are, surname and all, tell me everything, please.
My name is Kelechi Okafor, and I'm an actress. She's pretty much said it all.
Yes.
Actress, pole dance instructor, dance fitness pretty much, personal trainer, and just pretty much a loud mouth about black things.
Yes, which I do love. Like right now I'm in Kelechi's studio, which is amazing. Is this your only studio?
Yeah, so I had a studio in Clapton.
Okay.
I had that for a year, and then I wanted a bigger space, but more importantly, I wanted a space in Peckham, and now I'm in Peckham.
Yeah. Why Peckham?
I grew up in Peckham. Okay. All of my life has happened in Peckham. Mm-hmm. The bits that didn't happen in Nigeria when I was like up until the age of five. So it means a lot to me to be here, especially since the area is changing so quickly. Thought it would just be good to be part of it.
Of the change.
Yeah.
Wow. So, okay, you've gone from acting. Has dance always been in your world?
Yeah, I mean, it's just always been part of like the tapestry of my life. I've always danced. There wasn't a time I wasn't dancing.
Yes.
And I kind of fell into the dancing part of it. I was acting, well, you know, doing the acting stuff, and you wait ages to hear back, you wait ages to just get into an audition room. And I thought, okay, well, what else do I enjoy as much as acting? And it's fitness, because I used to do athletics and things like that. So I thought, yeah, I'll just become a personal trainer. And then everything else just kind of followed on from there. So I'm actually using the things that I've always had to kind of get the things that I want.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you said you got into fitness, but right now I'm surrounded by pole. So where did the pole dancing come into this?
Again, it was by chance. I'd been weightlifting for a while, and I thought, oh, I want to go and try something different, see how I can build my strength and stuff. And I went to a pole dance class, and because of the kind of work I've been doing already with myself, I flew through the levels, and they said, hey, do you want to teach? I thought, hey, why not? And then it just rolled on. Yeah.
Okay, now, me personally, when I think of pole dancing, I think, like, you're being naughty. One of the best fitness things possible.
Yeah.
Is that true?
I think it's one of the best ways to get fit, because the best thing you can do to get yourself stronger is to use your own body weight. Mm-hmm. With pole, all you have is your own body weight. You have to lift your body weight up, you have to spin your body weight around the pole. So we find that a lot of people, they develop a lot of strength and stamina in a pretty short amount of time.
Have you faced any struggles when it comes to the pole industry or the business as a fitness woman? What are the struggles?
I feel like most of the struggle is that we're not really, as black women, reflected in the industry, whether it's fitness, whether it's the pole dance community. There doesn't seem to be a space, which is why Delijah Franklin, she's based in America, she created Black Girls Pole. So we actually had a community for black girls who do pole dance, so they can see themselves. And it's really, really important to see yourself reflected onto yourself.
So you mentioned America to me. Now, the pole industry is big in America. Are we way behind? Are we catching up?
We're nowhere near. We're nowhere near because, I mean, that's not to say that the thinking of Americans is way different to ours when it comes to the sexualization of pole. But at the same time, people who teach pole dance, they want to run away from the sexualization of pole and be like, oh, it's not that sexual, it's about fitness. And no, actually embrace it all, because what's a great way to get, as a woman, I think it's a great way to get fit when you're actually using your sensuality at the same time. And the kind of pole dance that we do originated from strippers.
Wow. So you've mentioned pole in America, pole versus the pole in the UK. And you mentioned, okay, we're not really behind, but we are
behind. I mean, when I think of the styles, the various styles that the American polers have, we just don't have it. We're slowly kind of getting there. More people are interested in trying out.
Well, I just thought that there's no industry for pole.
There isn't, and everything's so English over here. It's so different. Like, men are just like looking at them. There's no passion.
For the money,
We don't have dollar bills.
No coins.
Yeah, you don't want coins pelted at you on stage.
Yeah, no.
So it just feels different. So even within America, there are differences.
What are the differences?
Well, New York wasn't as good as Atlanta. Atlanta, that is where the industry is. Miami, you know, that's where you really get the sense that people love these pole dancers.
I visited a club, trying to think of it, it was in New York. It was art. Like, the girls were doing things with their body that I was like, what? Like, they deserve everything. So I do feel like sometimes in the UK there's a stigma when it comes to, oh, they get paid strippers. You think pole and you think strippers. Not necessarily.
No.
Artists. Dancers.
And also, not every stripper pole dances and not every pole dancer strips. I hear these throwaway comments sometimes when people come to classes, or even on social media when people say, oh, if it doesn't work out, I'll just become a stripper. And I'm thinking, do you not understand how hard it is? You know, all you have to do is dance around the pole.
Really?
No.
Try it.
And so I'm always glad when it comes to a class and they try and they're like, my arms, my legs, my abs. Yes. It's about energy. Just using your energy, your kind of that internal energy that just is there all of the time, and putting it to use, putting it to something, and seeing the results. And I think that that's one thing that's missing in a lot of other aspects of fitness. You can do pole today and get results today in terms of you learn something, you learn a move, and then you learn another move and another move and another move, and before you know it, you're just flinging yourself around the place, and your body develops in the process.
Gosh. Yeah. So clearly I'm thinking, okay, acting, pole, fitness, it's all expression. But you express yourself somewhere else that I've seen. Social media, like, are you not afraid that sometimes being a bit too outspoken or, speaking your mind, do you think that will ever affect your business? Like, how?
I've been thinking about it a lot recently, and I honestly think that if you're not scared to say it, then it wasn't worth saying. So because I do often think about it, like, oh, you know, there's going to be a lot of backlash because trolls love my page.
So are there things that you kind of like, you know what, I'm not going to address that. I'm not even going to.
Yeah, I mean, it depends. It depends on my energy for the day. I mean, but Toni Morrison says that the very real function of racism is distraction. So the time that you spend trying to get someone to understand what you just wrote or what you just filmed, you could have used that time to maybe recenter and come with something else, or read something that would help to nourish you, or do something that could help to nourish you.
In today's generation, everyone is self-employed, everyone's there like entrepreneur, everyone's something. But what are the difficulties in having your own business?
Various. There are so many, especially if you haven't got to that stage yet where you can employ loads of people to do the work for you. You're having to wear so many hats. So I have to be like my own social media manager. I have to do my own marketing, my own PR. Like, make sure
for now.
Yeah, you know, and teach pretty much all of the classes because you have to have the income there to pay other people to teach the classes. And then you have to think of the rents as well, the expenses. A lot of the time, as small businesses, there are so many expenses that you've got to think about as well. So it's difficult, and then finding the time for self, because you want your business to do well, but at the same time you want to be well enough for the business to do well. So striking that balance, I think, is often the hardest part. I'm really irked by the fact that so many people do claim that they're self-employed and they're CEO of this and CEO of that, and they're not delivering on that thing that they said that they would give. And so being a business, if you really are self-employed, if you really are an entrepreneur, it's about the quality.
Yes.
And so as much as I believe in supporting black businesses, I want to support black businesses that are supporting themselves.
Yes. Working. Putting in the work. Let me see what you've done.
Exactly. And so it's important to me that every single class I'm delivering the best, that people are getting the best for, you know, and getting that experience that they came for. We have a lot of parties. Again, making sure people get the party that they experience, because people are sharing their happiest days with you.
Yeah.
You can't be lame. You can't have, oh, sorry, we don't have that today. Poll's not working.
No.
You know, things like that. Just making sure that every time it's the best that you're giving.
So do you feel like having your own business is like, at the same time, you're working for yourself now.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to, just like you're going to be working for somebody else, you have to treat it like you're working for somebody else, but for yourself.
Yeah.
So there's a seriousness to it all.
Yeah. It's a major part of that. It drives me and I drive it. The harder part comes in when you are bringing other people into the brand, especially when the brand is so centered around me, my personality.
But that's what it's about, doing things literally by yourself, for yourself, but at the same time, putting in the work.
Yeah.
Like, work. I feel like our generation, we don't really like to work.
No.
We like to look like we're working.
We like the titles.
Yes.
We like the titles.
But we're working on it.
Yeah.
What is your advice for someone wanting to get into the pole industry?
In terms of
creating your own studio, even becoming a fitness instructor, what is, yeah, how do we do it?
I think the first thing is to know why. It's with any relationship, any commitment, I'm sure you can attest to, even with marriage, you always have to remind yourself why.
Yeah.
Because when things get hard, you really need to know why you got into it. And the why will always serve the how.
Yeah.
Because if you know why, you know the people you need to attract to get the how.
Yeah.
And so that's how I see it, because everyone's path is different.
Okay, so we've spoken business. Now I wanna know, how do you make time for fun?
There's no time for fun. No, and there's no time for fun. I mean, for me, right now, the focus is to get the brand to somewhere, to get the studio to somewhere where I can say, okay, I'm off now, I'm going to go and do other bits. And there are so many other bits that I'm doing that are related to the Instagram stories and the thread. So I'm speaking on panels a lot, I'm doing workshops.
So the fun, it's not really there just yet, you're getting it in, but you're putting in the background work, which creates the fun, which I think is amazing.
Yeah.
Okay, now, at What To Obviously, I'm all about food. What is your, where was your number one place to eat? Where is it? Like, where are you gonna go?
Oh, number one place to eat. It would probably be Chinatown at the Dorchester.
Okay, yeah, I love a bit of Chinatown. Yeah, I like it, you're seeing it.
Yeah.
Okay, what is it you'll do? Just tell me something you do, what to do. Mm. You tell us you need to do this.
At anywhere in London.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so hard. Do pole.
Do pole. What else do you recommend right now? You guys need to watch this, maybe a TV show, a play. What should we be watching?
Obviously, Insecure.
Oh, come on. Oh, yes.
Yes. Obviously, Insecure.
Insecure comes with a story.
It comes with a story, and I can see myself.
Yeah.
You know, I can see myself. But I feel that the characters are where I feel like I'm at, where you're still getting your own way a lot of the time.
Yeah.
You're getting your own way and you have so much potential to do great things, but you keep getting your own way. And the stories is something I can relate to.
And lastly, where's your ultimate place to travel? Maybe you've been there, maybe you haven't been there. Like, where would you recommend?
Ultimate place to travel will always be Nigeria.
Yeah.
So many clubs and like things to do.
Lifestyle.
Yeah.
I literally feel like what we see of Nigeria isn't Nigeria.
No.
Like, there's a beautiful place.
Yeah.
Like, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Wow. So yeah, you guys have heard it all, seen it all, but Kelechi is amazing. Like, please, where can we find you?
KelechiOkafor.com.
Perfect.
Or at KelechiOkafor for the Insta stories.
Yes. You guys need to check her out, join, go online, check out the classes. I'm definitely going to be booking in with me and my girls.
Yes.
I'm going to definitely swing on some pearls. So yes, check it out, guys. Thank you for Snacks and Chats. I hope you have a lovely, lovely day. And thank you.
Thank you very much,
babe. Thank you.